I'm going to choose to believe I have not made a terrible mistake and just continue, hoping that this will all work out in the end. Well, would you look at that? I made a smart decision. I made a bet with a friend that I can cross this stream at full throttle. Looks like I lost. Will you help me recover my car? Maybe? That looks like the job for the F-750, not what I'm driving. Man, there's stuff way up here, too. Oh my god. There's stuff there. Ugh. Ew! Alright, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna recover. Let's take a look here. I kinda wanna just go driving on roads to make sure I can get everything exposed. Because right now, there's a lot of stuff I just don't even know that exists. And clearing some of that up will help. Like, look at all this stuff. I have no idea how to get back in here. Probably come this way. Like, view all of this stuff. There's another log station back there with medium logs. That might be the smarter place instead of coming up here for these. Go there for medium logs, because the delivery spot is there. That's what I'm gonna do. Okay. So what I'm gonna do here, we're gonna go this way. And this is just gonna be the F-750. We're not really gonna worry about getting anything. I'm guessing we're going through here? Yeah, because there's a spot there that comes down here over to there. All right, let's... let's do that, and then on the way back... I will go here... and then we'll come down this route and cross this stream so we can come over to this house and see what this is all about. And then I could probably get out this way if I had to guess. I bet you anything, this is technically a road that comes over here. And we can get to abandoned truck. Okay, let's try that. Let's try that. Okay. Gotta take a left. Sorry. Left turn. She used to hanging a right there. Alright, that's creepy. Don't do that. Yeah, this thing is definitely not the fastest machine on the market, but boy, it gets the job done. Okay, there's a warehouse there. Wow, they have a lot of stuff. Okay. I'm gonna assume metal rolls take up the same amount of space as metal beams, so two slot. Okay. Oopsie daisy. Well, this feels uncomfortable. Come on. Excellent. Now what is this? Have I picked this up yet? Oh no, everything from here on out is new, so I need to grab this. Lonely Island. Return the Dawn 71 to Petro's house. It wouldn't be that hard. Just time consuming, it seems. Alright, this is where I can get medium logs. This is good to know. This will be how I finish the that one quest line. Needs three more medium logs. I'll just get them from here. The one thing is, I don't know how I'm going to get them to the top of that mountain. I wasn't able to deliver anything to the top of the mountain. I had to get Lucid to do it. Maybe I'll have to do kind of what he did, where I just crawl a truck up there and set it up there so I can use the other vehicle as a winch point. That's probably what I'll need to do. Find a really heavy, beefy truck I can actually get up there and then just park it. That wasn't so bad. Okay, that's also wooden planks. You got all that. That's bricks. Okay. Keep an eye on what I've got over here. See if we can go this way. Get up on the rocks a little quicker, maybe. There we go. That's the way to do that. Okay. Rocket jockey. So I don't know if this is supposed to be a road or if it's just a creek that I can drive down, but whatever works, I guess. I kind of want to attach to the tree here. There we go. Not the best route to go. This place is nasty. Well, we learned not to drive down this place, or not to plan to drive down this place. This should be like a last resort kind of routing option. Technically, this was a road. Just the worst flooded road I have ever seen in my life. Screw you, fence. I already have that. Whoops. All right, so we've kind of mapped out a good chunk of the north part of the north part of this. We got that done. That's done. That's done. There's not really much along the outside of this. There's that wood framing house, but I've got that. We could go. I kind of want to go here. And then see if I can get down over here. Is there stuff over there? There is stuff over here. Alright, let's try going this way first. To this. Oh my god, there's stuff all the way down here. What? This is crazy. Hold on, let's rotate this around here. This is crazy talk. Alright, so if we do that... It doesn't... Oh my god. Oh man. Alright, so let's... All right, let's try that. There's gonna be some mission up there, I know it. So I'm gonna need to get up there eventually anyway. Might as well go have a look right now. I may not get the whole way up there tonight, but at least we can get started. What is this? Cabin Zone 2. What is this? I don't know what these are. What is cabin zones? don't know. Maybe it's a mission thing, and like, I'll have to bring stuff here to build like a cabin or something? I don't know. That kind of makes sense. There's the uppies area that I was thinking about going up. Man, we're making pretty good progress already. All right, custom bed, utility mount, roof rack. That's where I want it from. Yep, here's a mission. What's this? Deliver this trailer up the hill. Fuel. Deliver to the house on top of the mountain. That's a small scout flatbed. I can't even attach to that. Okay. Well, at least we got the mission. It doesn't seem too difficult. Up this hill. Oh, good Lord. Getting up here with a scout trailer looks easy. You're telling me, man. I may just, what I may do is I may come out here with a... a ramp flatbed and pull the scout trailer on top of a ramp flatbed on a like a regular off-road large truck and drag it out there that way. Rather than coming up here with a scout, come up here with a big old truck. And since I can't attach to a scout trailer, doesn't mean I can't haul it on top of a flatbed. Man, coming down would be a whole lot easier than going up. That's for sure. No, because the trailer has to be delivered. So if the trailer loads into the area, it should just pop the whole trailer in. Theoretically, trailer product on top of trailer and all. Well, yeah, yeah, that's my hope. Yeah, exactly. Come on. Up. Bend over. There we go. What? Yeah, okay. Okay, that wasn't so bad. Avoid the mud. Okay. There needs to be a way to tell where the ice is thick and thin. For the life of me, I cannot tell the difference. Like, I drove on a section that didn't crack underneath me, and it looks just like everything else. Crud. Can you get up through there? Can you do that? I don't think so. No way, dude. Okay. So that's not gonna happen. So really, the only way up to this sawmill is up here or up here. Let's go look at this path and see if it's easier than the other one. Because I know the other one's really difficult. That was the one we were getting up last time. Hello? There we go. It's like, can I have control of my camera, please? Bro, can I just... Can I go up the way I want to, please? Thank you. Alright, let's take a look at this route. So far, it looks easier than the other one. I'd be able to get up here. I'd be able to get up here. Oh man, why didn't we come this way? This looks easier. Like, I can get up here in my scout truck, sure, but I'd have a hard time getting up the other one in my scout truck. Oh man, this is so much easier. Okay. Yeah, we'll just go this way. Where? I want to be able to get my destination here. Okay. Okay, yeah, I can haul logs up that. That won't be a big deal. For those of you who weren't here for the last one, I'll go show you the other route on the way down. And it is significantly steeper. And we had a hard time getting anything up that one. I mean, we did it, but it certainly wasn't easy. Okay, so there's that. So... the other route was this one. Down won't be a problem. Obvious reasons, but hopefully you'll be able to see why up is more difficult here than it is over there. Plus the mud is thicker over here too. Jeez. This whole side of stuff is harder. Okay. So here's the area we were having problems with earlier. I got about halfway up this ramp and then got stuck and couldn't go any further. Yeah, see, the ramp isn't quite as smooth here. There's a much... yeah, see? There's a much more significant, like, up lip right there at the front. And I couldn't get my truck up that. Good to know that we can go the other way, though. And this thing has so many spare tires. I have yet to do, like, hardly any damage to a tire, let alone flatten it with how slow this truck goes. I guess you could use these tires as, like, as a repair vehicle for other trucks, though. Alright. I need to go ahead and pull out my ANK as well. Civilian. I kind of want to customize these. Because they look so unique. Okay. Engine. A wide handler fork or standard handler fork? Hype monster. That's weird. Harsh driver. Okay, well that doesn't have a whole lot of customization options, does it? Alright. Let's do the off-road gearbox there. Raised. This thing got muds. Ooh, it does. Oh, look at them big old chonky mud tires. Look at them big old boys. Yeah, let's throw those on there. Winch, we're gonna do the advanced medium. Engageable diff lock. Snorkel. High snorkel. Well, this guy can have a pretty decent amount of stuff, can't he? Small fuel carrier, small sideboard, maintenance frame, log carrier front. Rear bumper. Oh, those are mud flaps. Okay. Man, that's a cool little dude. Look at him. Oh, ho! Whoa, this dude goes! Whee! Man, that guy moves. Okay, what else we got? Any other new stuff? Or is this all the existing? Okay, yeah, here's that P16. Didn't I get some new stuff for this as well? Fine-tuned. This is available in Alaska. Full range of gears at a higher cost of fuel consumption. Muzzle. Oh man, look at that. Oh, that's so cool. All these different ranges. Oh, that is sick. Oh. Well, I think that is a good stopping point for tonight, everybody.